also suggests that the Systema Group SSTL board has approved the merger with Reliance Communication. Kritika Saxena joins in now. She's been tracking the story from the very start and she gives us more details. Kritika, morning.
Good morning, Sonia. So since June, the discussions have been on. There have been multiple to's and fro's and the various contours that were discussed. But yes, today is the day when the deal will be signed. In fact, I understand that the interim term sheet, which is typically signed before the board meets are done or the board meet clears the deal, have already been signed. And now it's the board final decision that will involve the complete deal completion. So net, SSTL and Systema Group, I understand, has already cleared the deal. The boards of both these companies have met and cleared the deals, and now Arcom's board meet is currently underway. I've gotten the details with respect to the swap ratio. So as you already know, Arcom is in discussions to acquire SSTL, that is Systema Shyam Teleservices, which owns and operates the MTS brand. SSTL is held by the Russian government, by Shyam Group and Systema Group. So what's going to happen is that the deal will be done through a swap ratio. The swap ratio, I understand, is about 1:11, which means that every shareholders of SSTL will get one share of Arcom for around 11 shares of SSTL. So that's the, as far as the swap ratio is concerned. The shareholding now, what I understand, is essentially going to be divided between Systema Group, Shyam Group and the Russian government, holding about 10% in the merged entity, as a result of which in the merged entity, Arcom promoters, that is the Anlamani Group, their shares will come down from about 60%, if I'm correct, to about 52 to 54% of the, as far as the merged entity is concerned. Now, how large will the merged entity be? As a result of the deal, Arcom is essentially going to be taking on the entire asset spectrum, subscribers and the employees of SSTL. But what's interesting is, and that really is, Sonia and Ekta, were the was the point of negotiation, and the main bone of contention was the liability. MTS has a liability of around 3,800 crore rupees, so that will not be taken on board. That's going to be taken care of by the promoters, that is the Russian government and the Systema Group. So Arcom basically takes on 9 million users across 9 circles, all the sites. The only one liability that will come in is the 2,500 crore rupee payout to the Department of Telecom, which will happen over tranches. So the entire spectrum base of 9 circles is going to come on board for Arcom. So the combined entity will have, so Arcom has about 110, so the combined entity will have around 120 subscribers as a whole, making it the fourth largest player in India. So of course the largest is Bharti Airtel, then comes Idea, then comes Vodafone, then comes Idea, and then now Arcom will be able to claw into market share. So this is something that Arcom has been waiting to do for quite some time. What happens to the combined debt? It comes down very, very marginally. So Arcom's debt woes still remain, but what does happen is it creates a significantly larger base, and going forward it gives them more leverage to be able to eat into market share. As far as what happens to Systema Group's holding over here, and SSTL promoters holding over here, they're pretty much exiting their standalone operations. They will perhaps at a later date look at expanding stake going ahead, but there won't be a separate inclusion of this. Also, they won't get both seats, and that's something that they have been negotiating.
Okay. All right, Kritika. Thanks very much for that. So the fourth largest telecom player is what Reliance Communication will become post the merger. But let's get Sudarshan Sukani now in to talk about any new